So then the benefits of, so let's talk about what would be the best. So if I'm a SaaS and I've made these investments, or you know, I'm making these investments now, what are the benefits that I'm going to see from a lawyer's perspective? Is that going to be time to market, time to revenue? What are the key things that are going to happen if I've done it right?
Yeah, so if you've done it right, there's going to be a product market match. And your all those things that McKinsey is talking about, where they've interviewed these CISOs and they say that, look, we'd love to go on the cloud. McKinsey, we'd love to do this. We see that all the value with pushing out these functions off of our systems onto the cloud. But data security and privacy are the major gating concern. So if I'm an investor and I see that a company has hurdled that data security and privacy challenge and has an infrastructure in place, I have a belief that there's going to be a better product market match than would otherwise be the case. And that's a big concern in terms of me knowing that this company is going to scale.
Gotcha. And from the same perspective, because I have shortened my time to revenue, time to market, I'm going to be that much more appealing to a potential venture firm that's looking to make an investment.
Absolutely. Yeah.
Okay.
So look, I spend every single day of my professional life, I am doing business-to-business tech transactions. And I will tell your listeners that without a doubt, the biggest issue in negotiating these deals, and I'm typically on the company side, so I'm typically on the service provider side, right? The biggest issue, you know, I'm dealing with general counsels at these companies that don't necessarily understand my product or what it does, but they sure as heck know data security and privacy are a big problem, right? So they're trying to push every risk onto my clients in terms of risk allocation provisions in the contract about data security and privacy. And the biggest drag on these deals is dealing with that and either educating the GC, the general counsel of the target company, or the relevant business stakeholders as to why their asks are unreasonable, or huddling with my clients and saying, hey, look, you know, this is actually a pretty legitimate ask. Is there any way we can accommodate? You know, in some cases, if God help us all, if the company didn't put the thought into developing a data security and privacy policy out in front, so now it's reacting to the customer's data security and privacy policy, then it just makes that drag infinitely worse. And one of the big problems is where you have every single customer imposes a different data security policy on you as a SaaS vendor. Now you have like dozens of different Bibles that you need to abide by on a go-forward basis. It makes life completely untenable.
Yeah, that's why. I mean, if you can say, hey, we're ISO 27001 certified or SOC 2 attested or FedRAMP or SAM, some recognized framework, you can kind of, you're in a position to push back on those asks.
Absolutely.
And I guess that's actually another advantage that I never really thought about, right? And as an attorney, this would probably be important to you, is that, you know, you can't push back from a position of non-strength. And having ISO or having SOC or something of that nature behind you is a position of strength. So you can say, I don't need that control. And we proved it. And we have an independent objective third-party audit that says so. Oh, okay, we don't need that. But if you're sitting there and you're negotiating the terms of a contract and you don't have that, you're kind of stuck between a rock and a hard place, right?
Absolutely. Well said. I'll do you one further. I don't know what the hell a lot of this stuff means in terms of data
Neither.
security and privacy.
Neither. I just bluff
But I do know what ISO certification means, and I love drafting in documents. So that's how lawyers work. We just work with what we know, and those objective standards are key because they're easy to slap into a document and easy to insist that the other party comply. So absolutely, those objective standards are often the straw that stirs the drink.